purpose, so we hid her away. Why do we always hide the truths we
find? Don't give me third! Why? Let her go!
Why? Everyone watching this video right now.
Is bring wine, Morty. When do I ask you for anything?
When do you? I haven't been to a full week of school in years. I don't know shit. And for what?
Well, you don't need to go to school, guys. Just come watch my videos. I'll tell you everything you need to know about the universe and how the world works. And I think Morty's probably learning more from Rick than what he'd learn at school. G'day smart people, my name's Dylan Danz, I'm a physicist from the land down under. Let's watch some Rick and Morty season 5. Before we do, if you want to win 500 bucks, all you gotta do is 4 things. It'll take you 30 seconds. Subscribe to this channel, subscribe to the channel in the description. Follow me on Instagram and comment down under. And I'll announce the winner on Instagram on the 21st of July. A huge thanks to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. There's a link in my description. The first 1,000 people to use this link will get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare. This channel is all about curiosity, discovery, and learning fun new things in a cool way. And Skillshare is just another place where you can take your curiosity even further. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of inspiring classes for creators. You can explore new skills, deepen existing passions, and get lost in creativity. There are classes for all skill levels that'll fit any schedule. If you want to make YouTube videos, if you want to make anime, if you want to learn how to do physics or math, there's classes for you. It's curated specifically for learning, so that means there's no ads, and they're always launching new premium classes, so you can stay focused and follow wherever your creativity takes you. I recently actually took a course called Learn Indie Filmmaking by Olev Defleur, and it was awesome. Pretty much learn how to make an indie film, which I think is super cool. So make sure you use that link in the description. It helps my channel out a lot. And the first 1,000 people get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare.
It's a big day.
We're gonna kill God.
Come again?
Christian God is real. He's been asleep for thousands of years. We're gonna sneak up there and kill him.
I don't believe in God, but I'm very interested in him.
Why is everything a fight with you?
You might want to learn this early, Morty. Life is a fight.
With Mr. Nick.
Life is a fight, guys. I like the whole philosophy of this show. They've got the right idea, these creators. They must be cool people. I bet you they're really cool guys.
I f***ed it up, okay?
It's okay, Morty. That's what you do. Let me deus ex machina this shit and let's go home.
Good movie.
Did you think I would let you die alone, Richard?
I'm so confused because someone last night, I saw a comment and they said I looked like Mr. Nimbus. I'm so tempted to get my Speedos out now and do that in the background. I won't subject you to that.
You die alone, Richard.
Jeez.
I think we should just be friends.
Oh, yeah, I get that. Guess we...
For both of us. Goodbye, Morty.
Hey, how's it going?
F*** off, I'm a time god!
Fighting.
We talked about time a lot in the last video, in that Loki one. So if you want to know some fun stuff about time, go check it out.
When squids started killing decoys started checking their decoys and learning that they're making decoys. That's making them seek out-
So now you've not only got all these decoys in the same little place, but you've also got a multiverse, so things are getting messy.
Capsules in all of your teeth. Do what you want with that. So just toss this whale-ass ocean wine in here and age it up a few centuries.
So time moves faster in there? It's like a Narnia thing?
Yeah, it's pretty much a Narnia thing.
Okay, but Jessica...
All you have to do is bring...
You could actually make something like this. Only catch is it would be in reverse. Ignoring the teleportation stuff. Like, let's just assume we figured that one out, right? Where could you teleport to make it so time ticks at a different rate? Well, around a black hole. But your time would actually slow down if you were within the vicinity of a black hole. And you'd have to be pretty close. And time would actually slow down quite a bit depending on how close you got to the black hole. So I should probably say this because I kind of just assume that it's obvious, but it's really not. And that's that the time, when I say time slows down around the black hole, it doesn't feel any different for you if you're, you know, near this black hole. So time, the rate of time will feel the same. So it's not like you're in slow motion around the black hole. It's just relative to someone further away. Your clock ticks slower, but it will feel the exact same for you, if that makes any sense. So to sum it up, a black hole can only be used to travel into the future. And unfortunately, you wouldn't be able to age wine like this unless you put everyone near the black hole and you left the wine far away. You might ask, well, how the hell would you know that, Dylan, if you don't have a black hole around to test your little theory there? That's a nice theory and all. Well, you see, we can test it here on Earth, actually. You don't need to have something with as much mass as a black hole. You can use things on the planet, like a mountain. So we have these things called atomic clocks, right? Very, very precise clocks. If you started one at the Big Bang, it would only be about 0.1 seconds off the exact time today. If you put one at the bottom of a mountain, you put one at the top of a mountain, over 24 hours, they will go out of sync by quite a bit. Now you might say to yourself, sure, Dylan, whatever, but how does this affect me and my day-to-day life? It doesn't. Doesn't mean jack. Well, actually it does, because every time you use GPS, or every time the satellites use GPS, which is extremely important, up in the sky, which controls everything, well, GPS needs to utilize the equations of general relativity, in specifically the time dilation equations, because if they don't, GPS will go out of sync enormously, because there is that time dilation effect for satellites and people on the Earth, because time would be moving slightly slower for us on the planet as we are closer to a large body of mass. And the difference in time is about 1 second every 60 years if you're a satellite in a geosynchronous orbit. So there you go. Thinking about things like black holes and neutron stars and things like that is not a waste of time. It actually leads us into these discoveries that change the world for everyone. And the final little fun fact I've got for you is that your head is actually aging at a different rate to your feet. Yeah, so your feet are actually aging a little bit slower than your head. And it's very, very, very minute, to the point where it means nothing. But it is happening. It is a thing. And we can calculate it.
Huh. Wait, but if the squids are decoys and we dressed as squids...
Well, I think I found their weak...
So these squid things are like a reference to the Matrix, right? Where in the real world, there are those giant squid things. I wonder where they're going to take it with the next Matrix. It'd be pretty funny if it was people inside.
It's making you loopy. Happy analysis mode.
Happy analysis mode to you, too.
Think you got the wrong house, bro. Now.
I love how he says that every time.
Already killing each other.
Well, you could have done something.
Not sure, actually. I've heard stories about this. We're looking at a possible Asimov cascade.
Sorry.
Asimov cascade. Asimov is a famous sci-fi writer who did a lot of the famous ones, and his best book series, Foundation. I saw Apple are about to make a series about it, so that'll be awesome. He's the guy who did, like, iRobot, you know, those robot laws and a bunch of other stuff.
Let's bring wine, Morty. When do I ask you for anything?
When do you... I haven't been to a full week of school in years. I don't know shit. And for what?
I've had so many comments by people saying they've learned more in these videos than at school, which, I'll take it as a compliment. But you know what? Knowledge isn't free, guys. You've got to pay attention. No, you don't always. I'm a big believer in just following your curiosity and having fun with stuff like this. I think you lose the passion for learning about how weird and cool this place is if you're just being, too disciplined, too respectful. It gets boring real quick. Richard Feynman, I love his quote where he says, "Do what interests you most in the most irreverent, undisciplined, and original manner possible." That's what I live by. If you're watching this video and you don't really know much about math or physics, and you have these stigmas in your head where you think everyone's just these boring nerds in it, you've got the wrong idea. That's not what it's like at all. It's like you get to be a big child, really, and just go study black holes and how the universe works, and everyone's just having fun with it on that side. It takes a bit of effort, sure, but I promise you it's worth it if you're interested in it. And if you're out there thinking you can't do stuff like this because you're not good at math, trust me, you can. All you need is some belief in yourself. Too many of you people had a bad teacher in school who told you you were too stupid or too dumb, and you go through the rest of your life thinking you're too stupid to do anything like this. And it's just not the case. We've all got a very similar brain, and you're capable. Trust me, I used to think the same crap. I used to think I wasn't smart enough, and then one day I decided to just you know, screw the haters. I'm going to give it a shot because I love it. And yeah, haven't looked back since. And now I'm basically a Jedi. Or a wizard. Whatever you prefer. That'll do it for today's video, guys. Thanks for watching. If you want to win that $500, make sure you do those four things. Subscribe to the channel in the description. Comment down under and follow me on Instagram, where I'll announce the winner on the 21st of July. Catch you later.